Hey guys, welcome to motorrides.com. My name is Amit Changani, and what we have with us today is the beautiful new Tata Nexon. As you can see, we have managed to get it to a place which is not very easily accessible. So for all of you adventure enthusiasts, first thing that you need to know is that this is a car which is relatively cheap and would get you to places which most of the normal everyday cars will not be able to take you to. In this video, we are going to talk about a few reasons why you should be buying this car, and at the end of it, we are also going to talk about a few things which some of you would consider before buying this, or should deter you from buying this one. So let's start by listing all the things out which should make you buy this one. Let's get going. So the first thing that you need to know about the Tata Nexon is the fact that it's a very, very bold design by Tata standards. It may not be to everyone's taste, but you have to give it to Tata for having created something which is so bold in terms of the way it comes across. It's not something that you get to see every day. Just look at the way this car has been designed, the use of colors and the use of inlays. To start off, you have to talk about this ivory inlay here, which is something that you have probably never seen before in an everyday car, and full marks to Tata for having created something which turns heads. In fact, when we were driving this car, we were stopped on the road by a lot of people, and they asked us as to what this car was, and they really liked the way it looked. Obviously, some of you may have a more sophisticated, understated taste, but having said that, this car to a majority of the Indian populace is something which is very funky and very, very likable. Talking about the elements on the outside, the things that really, really appeal to us are the LED DRLs up front, which look very nice when lit. As we mentioned before, these ivory inlays are something that you don't get to see on everyday cars. The cuts and the creases are also very unconventional. There's a very nice three-tone treatment given to the exterior. If you look at the color combination, you have this very SUV-ish kind of an undercladding, plastic undercladding, after which you have the body color and this ivory inlay and a contrasting color for the roof. So this makes it very special in terms of the way it looks. You may debate the loudness of it, but you cannot argue about the fact that it really, really looks very different. This is not something that you would get to see on an everyday car. The other aspects that we really like about the car are its very, very wide wheels, which is really surprising for a car which is placed in this segment. We really think Tata has done a very good job with that. The wheels look very nice. The ground clearance really gives it a very crossover-ish kind of a look, which increases its capability to go to places which most of the low slung cars cannot. Also at the rear, if you have a look, this roof mounted spoiler, these beautifully designed LED tail lamps, and this high slung kind of a look at the bottom really gives it a go anywhere kind of a feel, which is something which a lot of people are looking for. So in terms of the looks, this thing really scores. So that's one thing that should make you consider buying this one. This is something which looks like nothing else on the road right now. The second thing that really makes the Tata Nexon very, very appealing to a lot of people is the quality and the equipment on the inside. The cabin is really, really well set up, and it boasts of features which are very good for the price. So to start off, you have a keyless entry and a keyless push button start and stop. So that's the first thing. And once you start looking at the interior, obviously the steering wheel is shared with the other Tata family cars like the Bolt and the Tiago, but it still is very nice nonetheless. You have steering mounted controls, you have a freestanding infotainment screen with a lot of features, and this responds pretty well to touch as well. We would have wanted it to be a bit more bright, but we are not complaining here, knowing the price and everything. It's loaded with features. This thing comes with a Harman audio system, which sounds really well. I think it tops the class in terms of the sound quality that it delivers. The AC really, really chills. Even in hot conditions, it takes only a minute or two for the start chilling the cabin. It doesn't cool, it chills. Okay, apart from the freestanding screen you have a very nice instrument console where you have all the information you require in the form of an advanced MID, We've got distance to dry, instantaneous fuel efficiency, and a lot of other things that an everyday user really requires. So in terms of the interior and the equipment, this car is pretty loaded for the kind of price and the kind of segment that it resides in. We'll just give you a view of the center console as well. This comes with climate control. You've got all the menus here on the freestanding screen. You get a remote, boot lid opener. You got a reverse parking camera. You got a space here. You have an armrest. Although I'm not very fond of this one, this is a big knob which makes you think for a while that probably this will help you go off the road, but these are just modes which help you increase the efficiency of the car, get a bit more power in terms of responsiveness from the engine. So you can nonetheless choose from city, eco and sport mode. All in all, it's very well finished. The quality of the dashboard, the materials and everything is very nice. We don't have any qualms about the fit and finish and everything. If you want a car with a quality interior, you won't have anything to complain about. The third quality for which the Tata Nexon really stands out is the space inside. For a compact crossover, this thing packs in a lot of space. As you can see, there's a lot of headroom here, and the headroom comes aplenty at the back as well. Even the six-footers amongst you would not have any problem whatsoever. The seats are very nicely cushioned. I have a very good under-thigh support up front. The seats are very comfortable, no problem whatsoever. And at the rear as well, as I'll just show you. As you can see, I have just moved from my driver's position to the back seat, and still there is a lot of space between my knees and the backrest. So space is not a problem at all here. You also get AC vents at the back, so that's another good feature to have. I cannot say that you can seat three abreast here, but for two there is ample space, and probably you can squeeze in a third person if you so wish. Headroom, as I said, there's no problem whatsoever. So this car can carry four people in utter comfort. If you want to squeeze in a fifth person, he won't be very comfortable, but you can get a third person in the back seat in nonetheless. Also, one very important thing. The boot space in most of the compact crossovers is not something to write home about, but this one is different. If you look at the boot space in the Nexon, it's pretty good. If you compare it with the EcoSport, this is almost twice as much or probably more. So there's a lot of space here for putting your briefcases, your bags, and if you're going out with your family over a weekend, there's no dearth of space here. So the space is a very strong point of the new Nexon. The fourth standout feature of the Tata Nexon is its incredible ground clearance. As you can see from here, there's a lot of ground clearance, and if you're going soft-roading, although this one is not an all-wheel drive, but if you're going soft-roading, you don't really have to bother about the undulations on the road or small rocks or any other small rough surfaces which may create some trouble for the low slung cars. It simply goes over anything that a slight off-roading kind of an environment may throw at it. As you can see, this car is pretty smeared in mud, and we have come here traversing a road which was almost non-existent, and during our course we also went through some deep slush through some rough surfaces, and the Tata Nexon took all of that in its stride without a whimper. So if you're the kind of a person who wants to take his car out for little adventures, you have to be mindful that this is not an AWD. So if you're going to slushy places where the car may not find traction, you may be in trouble. But if the problem is clearance, then you know this car can really take you to places where a normal car would not be able to. So the ground clearance and the soft roading capability is a very strong feature of the Tata Nexon, and it should appeal to people who are very outdoorsy and want to go out over the weekends, not hardcore off-roading, but trying to go to places which are not accessible through mainstream roads. Fifth strong point of the Nexon is its diesel engine. It's an all-new motor by Tata Motors. It's a 4-pot 1.5-litre turbocharged diesel, and we really like it for its tractability. Obviously, it's not something which is very powerful, but it's very tractable, very usable. It's got ample pull at the lower revs. It's got a meaty mid-range. Up the rev range, maybe, you know, the power is not all that much, but it's a very usable unit. It's very frugal, and we drove it for about 250-300 kilometers today, and we did not have any problems whatsoever. It could have been a little more refined, but we don't have any problem with its efficiency, its tractability, its usability. It's a good engine, and we really think that Tata has done a good job with the diesel motor. Mind you, this is only the diesel motor that you're talking about, and the petrol motor is something that we are going to talk about in another video. And the sixth advantage of the Nexon is something that nobody can argue about. It's the price. If you are someone who is into crossovers and wants to go out with family or alone and wants to have a decent crossover, which may not be AWD but has enough capability to take you places where a normal car would not go, I think this is the best good-looking, well-equipped car that you can buy for the smallest amount of money today. This car in the petrol variant starts from 5.9 lakh rupees ex-showroom and goes till 9.5 lakh for the top of the line diesel variant with all the bells and whistles. That's the variant that we have with us right now, and that price we think is really good for the kind of stuff that this car can do, the kind of space that it packs in, the way it looks and the kind of engine that it has. So if you're looking for a car that can do a lot of things without having to pay a big price, the Nexon we think at this point in time is a car which saves you a lot of money. Now, since we have talked about the things that go in Tata Nexon's favor, we also need to talk about a few things which are not very good. And the first thing that we need to talk about is the engine refinement. We really think that the engine could have been a bit more refined, and it could have been a bit more punchy for the kind of size that it packs in. It's tractable, it's efficient, but there is no pronounced kick that you typically associate with a turbo diesel mill. And although there is a meaty mid-range, we really think that for a 1.5 liter diesel, it's a not sufficiently powerful as per you know, the industry standards. The seat of the pants experience is not as exhilarating, and it could have been a bit more refined. The second thing that we somewhat don't like about the Tata Nexon is the fact that there is a wee bit, a very mild sensation of the transmission judder. You can feel, you know, the transmission moving when you're driving the car, especially when you're moving, when you're swapping gears. We really think that that should have been refined a bit more, and that's not something that we are really fond of. The third thing, which may be a bit subjective and may not apply to all the customers of the Nexon, is the styling again. It looks good to us, especially in the blue color, stands out, but that bold, very expressive styling may not be to everyone's taste, and there are people who want a bit more subtle treatment to their cars, and for those people maybe this is a bit too loud. So, you know, if you're someone who doesn't want to get noticed too much, maybe you're going to have to look at some other car in the segment. That was our quick understanding of what really makes the Tata Nexon special and the things that probably don't, but we hope that it went some way to help you decide whether you want to buy this car or you don't. This is Amit Changani signing off for motorrides.com. We hope you liked this video. If you did, please like the video and subscribe to our channel, and we'll be coming back to you with more such videos very soon. Thanks a lot for watching.